So back when I was a young buck, I was chilling with my homeboy Mike Burton, and we was gonna go out to this club. And this fool had on some suspenders and also a straw hat. So basically, what I had to do was backhand that gorilla with the black hand side. He wasn't having that, wasn't liking it at all. And that's why I'm not allowed to eat raspberries in the spring anymore. What's good, my antique tech loving PD peeps? Thank you for watching this tutorial to learn the fast forward effect using PowerDirector Mobile. The fast forward effect makes it seem that an old school VHS player or DVD player is moving a video forward and playing it at regular speed to make it look like you're searching for something in a movie. Let's fast forward to the tutorial. On the timeline, I have a clip of me doing what I do. Talking about some nonsense. Now, I want to create sections of the clip where I speak at normal speed and sections where it will fast forward. So I want to move the playhead to a position where I want it to start to fast forward. And I want to tap on the clip and I'll tap split. Now this first section is going to be played at normal speed. Then I want to move the playhead to a position where I want the fast forward to stop. And I'll tap split again. So the second section is going to be fast forwarded and then over and over and over. So basically, I know where I want the rest of the splits to be. So I'm going to go ahead and make them real quick. Now that all the splits are done, we need to speed up the sections that we want to play in fast forward. So I'm going to move my playhead back to the beginning. I'm going to tap on this first clip that I want to speed up. Then I'm going to tap on speed. And I'm going to move the speed multiplier all the way up to 8 times the speed. Then I'm going to tap on the next clip and do the same thing until all of the clips that I want to speed up are done. Then I'm going to tap on back. And now we need to go ahead and add some TV static to the sections that we sped up. So I'm going to go back to this first clip. I'm going to tap on it. I'm going to tap on effects. I'm going to tap on glitch pack volume 1. I'm going to tap on disturbance. I'll tap on the settings. I'm going to tap on frequency. Move that all the way up to 100. I'm going to tap on strength. I'm going to move that all the way up to 100. And I'm going to do this with all of the clips that are already sped up. Then I'm going to tap on back. And I'll tap back. Now we want to add a fast forward button to the screen whenever the clips speed up. So I'm going to go back to the beginning here. I'm going to tap on this first clip. Then I'm going to tap on the overlay icon. I'm going to tap on photo. I'm going to tap on pictures. And you may have a photo that you can use. You can download one online and use for this. It's easy to find a fast forward button online anywhere. I'm going to tap on the plus sign. And it'll add it to the timeline right where my playhead is. Then I'm going to go ahead and tap on the button that I just added. And I'm going to place my finger over this arrow so I can size this up, drag it out. Now I want to go ahead and trim it so that it's only over the sped up section. So I'm going to hold my finger over the edge here where I have this white line. I'm going to drag it back and it should lock into place. Now I need to create multiple buttons. So I'm just going to go ahead and tap on duplicate. And it'll add one to the end. I'm going to tap on it, hold my finger down, then I'm going to drag it to the next section that's sped up. I'll tap it again. I'll place my finger over this edge and drag it out until it's the same length as the clip. I'll go ahead and tap on duplicate again. Hold my finger over it, drag it, tap it again, and then trim it down to the same size as that clip. We can't use multiple effects on a clip in PowerDirector Mobile. To get around this, we need to create a composite, and we're gonna do that by producing what we've done so far. Then we'll go ahead and add that clip back into the mix so we can add another effect to the composite to make it look black and white whenever the sped up part is playing. So we're gonna go ahead and produce this by tapping on the produce button. We'll go ahead and choose more output options. I'm gonna do the highest quality. And then I'm gonna tap on settings. And we want it to be internal storage. So we wanna see where it's gonna go so I know where to look for it. And it tells me right here where to look for it when I go back into the file. So I'm good to go there. I'm gonna leave it like it is. And I'm gonna go ahead and tap on okay. Then I'll tap on next. I'm just gonna go ahead and move this down, get rid of it. I'm gonna go ahead and tap on done. I'll tap not now. Then I'll tap back. And so now we need to bring that composite that we just created into an overlay track. So I'm gonna go ahead and tap on the overlay icon. I'm gonna tap on video. I'm gonna go to the location where the video was saved. I'm gonna tap on the video and tap the plus sign. And then I'm gonna go ahead and tap on okay. Now I'm gonna tap on the clip and I'm gonna resize it by holding my finger over the arrow here. And now that we have the composite on the timeline, we can add the black and white effect. So what we need to do is tap on the clip on the main track where it sped up, and it'll move our playhead exactly to where it was split. So now if we tap on the clip on the overlay track, the composite that we just added, we can tap on split, and it'll split it in the exact same position. So just keep tapping the clips on the main timeline, tap the clip on the overlay track, the composite, and tap split until you got all the splits identical to the ones above. Now that all of the splits are aligned, you can go ahead and get rid of all of the clips above it. So the main track and that first overlay track, you can delete all of that. And now we can go ahead and add the black and white effect to all the clips in the middle. So we'll tap on the clip. We'll go ahead and tap on effect. We'll tap on black and white. And then we'll tap on the next clip that we need the black and white on. So let's go ahead and play this back and see what we're working with.
So back when I was a young buck, I was chilling with my homeboy Mike Burton, and we was gonna go out to this club. And this fool had on some suspenders and also a straw hat. So
we are definitely moving at a different speed. Our channel is dedicated to teaching you how to use PowerDirector Mobile. So if you want more PowerDirector Mobile tutorial love, smash the subscribe button. If you don't own the app and you like what you see, I'll leave my affiliate link to try PowerDirector in the video description. Using it helps support the channel so I can make more content for you. Shout out to Team PDU for their support and for clicking the join button under this video. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.